head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Paul has the ball set how he wants it. And we're just about ready to kick this game off, folks. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Wildcats and their ground game's always been sensational. It's not always one guy, Herbie. Sometimes they've got two or three that can carry the load.
And that's what makes it so tough for this defense, is you're not focusing in on just one guy. You're focusing in on really an entire scheme. And because of that diversity, I think it makes it more of a challenge. And you got to be better tacklers in the open field. And I think that's really what they've stressed all week, is tackling and gang tackling and getting to the football.
Hard to get to guys and make tackles in space.
That was just a case of one lineman dominating another and making the play.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. Trying to set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. He's pushed out of bounds at the 44-yard line.
Really a nicely thrown ball and a good job by the receiver to run right under it.
From their own 44-yard line. First down. Nice run, and he's brought down.
That brings him second and five.
Throws it in a hurry. They'll bring him down around the 36-yard line.
He is such a good target, really anywhere on the field. But they like to get him the ball in short to medium range situations.
And we'll take a break while the injured player is attended to. From the 36-yard line, first down. He's scrambling. He gets sacked on the play.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
Third down and a couple of miles here. Ball on the 43-yard line. Empty backfield. Quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. They bring him down again. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds and those receivers might have been open.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. Payne awaits the snap. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Matthews gains 8 yards on that play. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. The Wildcats lost a player earlier. Herbie, this is a big blow to this team. Doesn't look like he's going to play any more football today. He's tackled at the 38.
I'm a huge fan of the play-action pass in college football, because play-action
it really puts a lot of pressure on defense. The defense gets caught up and concerned about the running game, and it puts them out of position. And it makes the throwing lanes for the quarterback and the windows that he's trying to find much easier to find for a quarterback and a receiver to pick up big yards like we just saw there.
Second and eight. Ball on the 40. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Throws it and oh, he dropped it.
You don't want to ever give your opponent a second chance, but that's exactly what they did by not making that interception.
Throws to the receiver, incomplete.
He'll learn he doesn't always need to use his cannon. Sometimes precision is more important than power.
Cohen, back to return it. Gets out to about the 31. I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. He scrambled. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. And he's tackled right around the 40. That's a gain of 9.
That brings up second and one.
Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. Five wide. Makes it out to about the 50. Tackle made at about the 41. So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. They'll spread the field with five wide. That's a great tackle at the 40.
That'll bring up third and inches.
Across the middle, caught. He's taken down at the 32-yard line.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back to pass.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 32. Tackle right around the 20. Across the middle, and he's taken down at the 12.
That brings in second.
So at the end of one, no score here. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. Inside and tackle quickly. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Brought down at about the 15-yard line. The defensive end came through to put him away.
Nice job of utilizing his athletic ability to get in there and then make a sure tackle.
They'll call on the field goal unit here. Trying to take the lead by a field goal. The kick is up, and it sails through the uprights. Looks like they're ready for the kick. from his own goal line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Tackled after a decent pickup. Matthew comes away with 5 yards on the carry.
That makes it 2nd and 6.
2nd and 6 coming up here. Ball on the 22-yard line. Runs outside for a nice game. Draw here. And down he goes around the 27-yard line.
You keep gaining negative yards, and you put yourself in a position of having to make bigger and bigger plays. Puts a lot of pressure on that quarterback.
From their own 27-yard line, it's 2nd down. And they make the stop at the 41-yard line. Makes the 1st down catch. It holds. He zips it. And he's immediately tackled. We've got a 1st and 10. Ball on the 34. He gets out to about the 32-yard line.
That's a gain of 2 on that. That makes it 2nd and 8.
Makes it to the 24. It's 3rd down, and they're about the length of the football away from the 1st down marker. Makes it to the 22-yard line. It's the 9th play of the drive. Run up the middle. A gain of about 4 yards on the draw. 2nd down and 5. Ball on the 18-yard line. And he hits him hard at the 24-yard line.
That brings him 3rd and 12.
It's the 11th play of the drive. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch.
That's good decision making there and mechanics by the quarterback. He knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but he looked off the other receivers first.
It's 1st down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Touchdown. He really plowed his way.
Once you get inside the 10-yard line, this halfback is automatic.
He makes the PAT. A 12-play, 85-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Both defenses really played well so far, Herbie.
Well, up to this point, both defenses have dominated this football game. We'll see if they can hold on to that mentality the rest of the way.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Scrambling around. They'll bring him down at the 30-yard line. The quarterback trying to make a play.
Well, he did a nice job of getting some yards there on the scramble, but he needs to learn to slide to avoid those big hits.
Quick throw. He gets hit out of bounds around the 43-yard line. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
Well, this comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. He's tackled at the 49-yard line. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Wildcats use their second timeout. So the completion goes for about 5 yards and a first down.
And that's just great execution on that short pass play.
Now he's flushed and they got it.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
He's on the run and he's going to be sacked. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. The defense didn't stop the pass, but they stopped him short of the sticks.
And that's the important thing here. Allow him to make the catch, but make sure you tackle him before he gets to the first down marker.
Perkins is back deep to return. A great first half comes to a close. 7-3, Bobcats.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack here in the studio, as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
So far, so good for both offenses in terms of taking care of the football, but now the defenses are ramping up the sense of urgency in terms of trying to get the ball back for their offense.
Absolutely. You got to find Reese. These ball hawks on defense, they need to find the football. They need to make some big plays, create some turnovers. How about using that hit stick a little bit? How about knocking somebody silly and making them drop the football? I mean, defense's number one priority is trying to turn the football over, try to make a big explosive play for your offense. So they can do more damage, and they can take the ball down the field. So those ball hawks need to show themselves in the second half.
Just about time to start the second half. What do you think Herb Street's first point of analysis will be?
I don't know. Something to do with quarterback play, I'm sure. We always got to hear that stuff all the time. It's all about the quarterbacks.
Brad and Kirk ready for the second half.
He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 20-yard line. Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up. And he is drilled at the 23. from their own 23-yard line. Second down. Fires out to his receiver, and he's tackled around the 33-yard line. It to the 44. From their own 44-yard line. First down. Gets it quickly to the tight end, but it's dropped. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 46. Fires out to his wideout. Tackle made at the 49. Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback.
Well, that's what it's all about for these guys. If you can turn up the pressure, you'll create more chances for your defense.
This defense has been bringing the blitz and is having success getting to it. The defense wants to dig in here to avoid any letdowns. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. Second and 10, ball on the 20-yard line. Quick shot to the tailback and through his hands. And that one probably should have been picked off.
Yeah, are you kidding me? There's a blanket around that receiver. Somebody else had to be open.
They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. Going deep, lays it out there, and it's caught. He's taken down to the 37-yard line. It's first down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air. Taken down in the backfield.
I think anytime you lose yardage, it's frustrating as a ball carrier. It's very frustrating as a play caller. It makes you a little bit more hesitant maybe to go back to a certain play. The biggest thing you want to do as an offensive coordinator is get the offense over the sideline after the series. Make sure everybody's on the same page, and then show the confidence that you still have in them despite this play that you're going to go right back to the running back and trust that offensive line.
And once again, they'll come to the line trying to convert on third down. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. Good open field tackle. It's up. And it's wide left. No good. And the kicking team goes to the sideline very disappointed.
Usually in rainy conditions, it's a bad snap or hold that's the problem. But everything looked good to me. You can place the blame solely on the kicker right there.
The offense is looking to be a little bit more successful with this drive as they had to punt the ball away the last time they had it. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. from their own 36-yard line. It's second down. And he's sacked. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds, and those receivers might have been open.
Came up short. You know, sometimes the officials' judgments can have a big impact on a game.
From their own 43-yard line, first down. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line.
That makes it second and six.
Great tackle at the 42. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 42-yard line. Fires it out. Tackle right around the 36-yard line. For a nice run. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Gains his way to the 19-yard line. From the 19-yard line, it's first down. Get him in the backfield for a loss.
He just timed the snap count there. It really made a nice play.
Through three quarters now, and still the defenses are shining. The Bobcats lead it by four. This final few minutes is going to determine this one. Tight ball game. Action set to start here in the fourth quarter. And he tackles him hard at the 18-yard line. And this is the 11th play of the current drive. Fires it quickly. Finds his receiver. Touchdown.
Tremendous example of the type of chemistry that these two players enjoy. When a quarterback and a receiver are on the same page, good things tend to happen.
And he adds the extra point. It was an 11-play, 69-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. Oh, he got nailed on that one. We're about set to start things up again. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. He's out to the 30, he's to the 40, the 50, And they make the stop at the 47. So they pick up big yards on the option keeper.
I thought he's going to break that one for a touchdown. You couldn't draw that up any better.
First and 10. Let's see if they can build off that great run. He's going to try and scramble. And he's taken down around the 40-yard line.
Game seven on the play. That'll bring up second and three.
Let's go one more. Mike 52, Mike 52.
He scrambles. And down he goes at about the 39-yard line.
That'll bring up third and two.
It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Well, after that injury, we'll get to see the backup quarterback here. Brought down right around the 30.
That's a deep one. That makes it first and 10.
Makes it to the 28-yard line. 2 yard gain on the quarterback keeper.
That makes it second and eight.
From the 28-yard line, second down. The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a five-wide set, and the defense counters with their dime rush. The throw incomplete, one of his receiver. Just under three to go in regulation. Quick out to his receiver. They'll bring him down at the 18. The 10. Quick throw out to the receiver.
Second and one.
It's the ninth play of the drive. Quick pass, man open, and he dropped it. They've been two for two on third downs in this drive, and they'll try to convert again here. He tackles him for a loss.
The defense was playing the run all the way. They got it right. Nice work.
That makes it fourth and four.
Immediately. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Nice run, and he's brought down. Matthews gained 7 yards on that play. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Just under 2 minutes in the game. Run up the middle, and that's a first down.
First down, and now they have an opportunity to run some more time off the clock.
Here's a run. The Wildcats, they're going to have to call their third and final timeout. Matthews gains about 5 yards on the run. Third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. to the 40. Gains his way to the 43-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 43-yard line. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. He'll go down to one knee. This one's in the books. The Bobcats get the victory, 14-3. That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.